Hello everyone and welcome to Dynamics Academy. And with this video we are starting a new series called Microsoft Dynamics 365 CRM Interview Questions and Answer Series, where you will find all the Microsoft Dynamics CRM related interview questions and its answers. And in this video we will see following Microsoft Dynamics CRM 365 interview questions, where you might get some direct questions like, explain what is entity ownership, how many different types of entity ownership are available in Dynamics 365, where do we define or specify entity ownership, and lastly but the most common interview question that you might face in your Microsoft Dynamics CRM or Dynamics 365 interview is that, what is the difference between user or team owned entities and organization owned entities. So basically this video is going to focus on entity ownership concept of Microsoft Dynamics 365 platform. So let us now see what is entity ownership. In Dynamics 365, most of the entities, including custom entities, are owned by the organization or by a user or a team. And there are also some business entities that do not have owner, where the ownership is defined by its parent entity, for example, discount entity. And the type of ownership defines some of the operations that can be performed on a record of that type. So the main purpose of entity ownership is to identify, based on the entity ownership, that you will be able to perform certain actions or certain operations on that particular records or not. So in technical terms, where do you define or which property contains the entity ownership? The ownership of an entity is defined in a metadata property called ownership type. So this property is present at all the entities. It is a property of entity metadata schema. So having said that, let us now see different entity ownership types. The first type is called organization owned. It contains data involving something that belongs to or that can be viewed by the whole organization. Organization owned entities cannot be assigned or shared. For example, product entity, which are owned by organization, and these entities have an attribute named organization ID. The next type of entity ownership is called business owned or business unit owned entities, which means that entities which belongs to a business unit. These entities have an attribute named owing business unit. We will see which entities fall under this category. And the next type, or which is the most commonly used entity ownership type, is user or team owned. So the records of these kind of entities can be assigned to a user or a team. These entities contains data relates to customers such as accounts or contacts. Security can be defined according to the business unit for user or a team. These entities have attributes named owing team and owing user. And last entity ownership type is called none. These entities does not have any owner, and the ownership of these kind of records is defined by its parent records. Let us now see the different examples of entities by ownership type. The example of organization owned entities are article, article templates, general properties, competitors. And the example of business unit owned entities are business unit, security role, team and user. You can find lots of examples for user or team owned entities like accounts, contacts, opportunity, order, invoice, etc. Majority of the entities falls under this category. And lastly, the example of none ownership type are address, attachment, competitor address and discounts. For custom entities, you can have only two types of ownership, that is organization owned or user or team owned. So you cannot create a custom entity with ownership type as either business unit owned or none. You can only choose between organization owned or user or team owned. So let me now show you where you can define or specify the entity ownership. At the time of creating an entity, you have to specify certain attributes like the display name, plural name. So at the same time, that you have to specify the ownership field. So where you can select either user or team owned or an organization owned. You do not have business unit and none values here. So that means that you can only create a custom entity which can be either owned by an organization or a user or team. So let me now show you practically on our trial instance. So this is my trial instance. So we have to navigate to settings area. customizations. I have created a custom solution. I am opening that record. So if I add a new entity, then it is going to open entity creation form. So where you have to specify the display name first, and here you have to select ownership attribute. So you can either select user or team or organization owner. So the default value is user or team, and you have to be very careful while selecting this option, because once you have selected this option and saved this record, you will not be able to make any changes after that. So let me now show you the examples of different entity ownership. So here you can see that account entity is owned by user or team, and I am not able to make any changes on this ownership. And at the same time, if I navigate to the address entity, which is also again out of the box entity, then you can see the ownership is none. So addresses within CRM cannot be owned by any other entity or user. We now show you the business unit entity as well. So you can see the ownership here is business unit. That means that it is a business unit owned entity. And lastly, here you can see the article entity. So article entity is organization owned. So I'll show you an example of each of them. And we have also seen where you can define the entity ownership, but at the same time, you have to be very, very careful while deciding the ownership term, because once the ownership is set, you will not be able to update it later. So be thorough while making the decision. So why it cannot be changed after that? Because the moment you select the entity ownership and you save that particular entity, then it creates additional attributes for that entity, like owing user, owing team, owing business unit, and owner ID. So consider a scenario that you have selected user or team at the time of creating a custom entity called employee leaves. So after some time, after 6 to 7 months, your data is created and all the values in these four fields are there, and you decide to suddenly change the ownership type. Then what you have to do, whatever the extra attributes that were added to that entity has to be reverted back, and also the security access levels and sharing of the records, if these records shared to any other user, then all these things has to be reverted back. So that is why what Microsoft has done is, so they have stopped allowing users to revert back or change the ownership field once it is created. So that is why it becomes very, very important to decide the entity ownership at the first place itself. So after you have created that entity, you will not be able to change the ownership type of that entity. Having said that, let us now see what is the difference between user or team owned entities and organization owned entities. So for organization owned entities, it contains data involving something that belongs to or that can be used by whole organization. While in case of user or team owned entities, data involved can be accessed or views as per the security access of that particular user or team owing that record. So organization owned entities cannot be assigned or shared, because by default, the definition itself says that it should be viewable to entire organizations. While in the case of user or team owned entities, it can be assigned to a user or a team. At the same time, it can be owned by a user or a team. Organization owned entities have an attribute named organization ID, while user or team entities have an attribute named owing team and owing user. And lastly, user can have either full or no access on an organization owned entities, while for a user or team entities, user can have none, user level, business unit level, parent child business unit level, or an organization level access on such entity records. So where you define these different type of access levels, you have to define in the security role of that particular user. So let me now show you security role page for an organization owned entity and a user or team owned entity. So let me now go to our trial instance. So I open a CSR manager security role, right? So let me now show you the difference between organization owned entity and a user or team entity. So as we have seen that an account record is an user or team owned entity. So now for this account, for CSR manager role, I can define that different access level. So for create privilege, I can define either none, user level. If you click once more here, you can, it will increase it to business unit level, then parent child business unit level, and if you see a full green circle, then it is called organization level access for create permission. So let me now revert it back to the user level. And at the same time, we have seen that product is an organization owned entity. So you do not have assign and share privileges for this product entity, similarly for property entity as well. So these three types of entities are organization owned entities, and you do not have assign or share privileges, and at the same time you can have either no access or full access. That means if you click here one time, it is going to remove all the privileges, and the next time if you click full. While in case of user or team owned entities, you can define five different levels. So having said that, these were the key differences between organization owned entities and user or team owned entities. So on that note, I will end this video. If you find this video useful, then please do like, share and subscribe to Dynamix Academy YouTube channel. And if you have any questions or queries, if you have any suggestions or feedback on this video, please do share them in the comment sections below. And if you would like to have answers to some of the Microsoft Dynamics CRM interview questions that you have faced, so please put them all in the chat window or the comment sections below, and we will be happy to answer them all. On that note, I take your leave. Hope to see you all in the next video. Till then, bye bye and take care.